part and stick it in and lock it, and then you know, you attach it and kind of build it like that.
No, it's not circular. It's a. It's more like a tunnel. Right?
Yeah, it's square. So there's two long base bars, and then vertical bars. All the way down with spray nozzles to coat the whole thing in hydrogen peroxide.
How long, how much exposure do you have to have?
I don't know. We're going to basically test it. We have some chemistry professors that we're talking to about it, what they think. But, yeah, we'll spray it down for a certain amount of time, let it sit for maybe 10 minutes, and then get, you know, the little cultures and see if we have enough kill rate, and then just, you know, vary it based on that.
You know what I'm thinking about? If it's over a distance and you have various spray nozzles, you don't get a big concentration in one area, as opposed to a shorter span with a heavy concentration.
Yeah.
And then where you go in, slow down, move out slowly and let it take effect on the way out, more or less.
Well, what it is like we have three stages. So it's the first stage is like a high pressure and wash it down with
it's
high
water.
Pressure water. And then it pulls in, and stage two is basically like a mist of hydrogen peroxide that we spray on it for so much time.
Right.
And then cover the whole thing, let it sit there, and then spray it with high pressure water on the way out. So, and the nozzles are designed to be to evenly distribute the water on, you know, on a cone.
Yeah. When these